Hi students, I hope all are you doing well in this pandemic situation. So today I'm going to discuss the very elementary or very preliminary part of the chemistry. That is, what is the chemistry and what is the importance or significance of the chemistry? What is the reason we are studying this chemistry since our childhood? Why it is mandatory to study the chemistry? That is, I'm going to explain in detail about the importance of chemistry. First and foremost, what is chemistry? Chemistry is the branch of the science which deals with the chemicals, chemical equations, chemical reactions. Any aspect which is related to the chemicals is nothing but chemistry. Now, coming to the focal point of this lecture, that is importance or significance of chemistry. In order to understand the importance or significance of chemistry, I would like to give one of the exercises to you. Dear students, please stop breathing for at least 20 seconds. 20 seconds. Just count 20 numbers. It will finish the 20 seconds. Do it on your own. No need to do now. You can do it on your own whenever you have the time. So just tell me, how was your feeling during this particular 20 seconds? It was erratic. It was horrible, isn't it? Now, why when you stop breathing for at least 20 seconds, you have felt erratic or horrible? What is the reason behind it? What do you mean by stopping the breathing? Stopping the breathing means you are stopping the entry of oxygen into your body. You are not giving the access to the oxygen into your body. Now, what happens whenever you're stopping the entry of oxygen into your body or our body? What exactly happens? What is the role of the oxygen? What is the role or function of the oxygen in our body? Oxygen is the fuel for the functioning of each and every part of our body, each and every organ of our body. Oxygen is the fuel. Now, whenever it is a fuel, when we are stopped breathing, the fuel is not entering into our body. When the fuel is not entering into our body, then what is happening? The fuel is the one which is responsible for the operation of any of the organ. Now, when the fuel is not there, the organ stops functioning. Each and every part of the body stops functioning, including the brain. And what is the important role of the brain? Already you are well versed with it. Brain is the major part or main part of the central nervous system. And because of the brain, only the signals are being sent to each and every part, each and every organ of the body, by which each and every organ or part of the body is functioning properly. Now, whenever the brain is not functioning properly, whenever we are not giving the access for the oxygen to enter, when we are stopping the breathing, then brain cells start to die. When the brain cells stop to die, so definitely, as the brain cells are very important for passing the signals, each and every organ, each and every part of our body will stop to function. Eventually, we will die. And it has been proven that whether he is a yoga guru or whatever it is, any of the person can hold breathing. Any of the person can survive without breathing for a maximum of 3 minutes. Not more than that. Not more than that. Now, based upon this, we can easily say that oxygen is having the pivotal role in our body. What do you mean by pivotal? Very, very crucial role in our body, right? Very, very crucial role in our body. So this is about the oxygen role in our body. Now coming to the next important thing or substance which is needed for our body is the water. So water, what is the role of the water? There is no need to discuss. There is no need to discuss. So many important aspects are associated with this particular water. So much significance is associated with the water. But I will try to emphasize this. Regulates body temperature. Now, dear students, I hope that each and every one of you are familiar with the fact that our body temperature is being maintained at 37 degrees centigrade, isn't it? Now, how could the body maintain the temperature at 37 degrees centigrade? This is due to the water. The water is the fluid. Water is the fluid because of which 37 degrees of temperature is being maintained in our body. In our body. That is, water is the one which is regulating the body temperature at 37 degrees centigrade. Now, one question might be lingering in your mind, in your brain, since your childhood, that why only 37 degrees of temperature is being maintained in our body? What for? So we are saying that the water is the one which is maintaining the body temperature to 37 degrees centigrade, but why only 37 degrees centigrade? What not? Why not the other sort of temperature? What could be the reason for it? So dear students, do remember that our body is composed of so many biomolecules like amino acids, proteins, lipids, enzymes, deoxyribonucleic acid, ribonucleic acid, so many of that, right? So what are all these biomolecules? All these biomolecules are the chemicals, students. All these biomolecules are the chemicals. Now, in order to undergo the chemical reactions, because the chemicals will undergo the chemical reactions, right? So without undergoing the chemical reactions, the chemical cannot generate the desirable products, desirable reactants, or desirable reactions by which the temperature of the body is being maintained. And not only that, each and every part of the body will function properly. Right. So the chemical reaction should occur in our body, as our body is made up of or composed of so many chemicals in it. Now we are well versed that chemical reaction is directly proportional to temperature. Right. So since chemical reaction is directly proportional to temperature, so definitely we can say that some sort of temperature should be maintained. That sort of temperature which is being maintained in order to carry out the chemical reaction between the biomolecules which are a part of the body in order to get the desirable products and the desirable reactions for the proper functioning of each and every biomolecule in the body, the temperature is to be maintained at 37 degree centigrade, and this is being maintained by the water content. Now the question is, why only 37 degree centigrade? Why not more than that? Dear students, we are well versed that chemical reaction is directly proportional to temperature. So chemical reaction is directly proportional to temperature doesn't mean that we can increase the temperature what we want. We can hike the temperature how much we want. It is not that the case. So definitely there will be a lot optimal level. Optimal level of temperature, optimal level of pressure, optimal level of volume. Every parameter if you consider for whatever whatever the thing is. So definitely optimal level of that particular thing, but that particular parameter is required. Not more than that, not less than that. For example, in order to simplify the things. So chemical reactions can be correlated with cooking. Chemical reactions can be correlated with cooking. So during the cooking of any of the curry, what you will do, you will add all the ingredients in the dish and you lit the flame. So as we are supplying the temperature, what happens? All the ingredients mix up. Finally, you will get the curry. Now, to how much extent you have to supply the temperature? If you supply more amount of temperature, what happens? The whole curry will burn. In the similar fashion, the chemical reaction should occur in our body, which may lead to the desirable reactions and desirable products by which each and every biomolecule present in our body will function properly. But how much? 37 degree centigrade. So if you maintain more than that, so definitely as the curry burnt, so definitely our enzymes, DNA, RNA, proteins, amino acids, each and everything burn, right? So simply, students, how the proteins are formed? The proteins are formed by the combination of amino acids. What are the amino acids? Chemicals. And what is the protein which is formed? It is also the chemical. So this is the reason why we need to maintain the temperature at 37 degree centigrade in our body. And that sort of temperature which is being maintained in our body is because of only the water. That is the reason it is regulating the body of the temperature. That is, it is regulating the body temperature at 37 degree centigrade. This is the optimum temperature for the chemical reactions to occur between the biomolecules which are present in the body in order to produce the desirable reactions and desirable products by which each and every biomolecule of the body will function properly, by which each and every organ or each and every part of our body will function properly eventually. The whole body will function properly. Right. So scientific studies suggest that without water, the person can survive up to 3 days. It is possible. Now, based upon that, we can say that this particular water is having the substantial role. So without the oxygen, we can survive only up to 3 minutes. It is having the pivotal role, which is very, very crucial role. And without the water, the person can survive for 3 days. So it is also having the crucial role, but when compared to the oxygen, which is having the very, very crucial role. Now coming to the next important substance. That is the food. Now, dear students, all of you are well versed. What is the importance of food? I'm not going to discuss the importance of food in detail because all of you are known. But So simply to sort out what is the importance of the food is it gives the energy. So without the energy, none of the part of the body will function properly, right? So without the energy, we cannot function. We cannot move here and there. We cannot do the work. Energy is nothing but the capacity of doing the work, right? So in order to get the energy, so definitely we have to consume the food. We have to consume the food. Now the scientific studies revealed that a person can survive without the food up to a maximum of 3 weeks. 3 weeks. So when we can survive without the food up to a maximum of 3 weeks, provided adequate amount of water is taken during these 3 weeks. So we are saying that up to 3 weeks a person can survive without the food, but the condition is during this period, so definitely the person should take or consume the adequate amount of water. Adequate amount of water. That is the condition. Right? Now, so without the food, we can survive for 3 weeks. It means that, so definitely we can say that it is having the crucial role, but not more than the water, and water is not more than the oxygen. Right. Now oxygen is pivotal, right? Very, very crucial for our body. Water is substantial, that is very crucial for our body. And food is crucial for our body. Now the oxygen, which is having the pivotal role, without which we cannot imagine 3 minutes. The water, which is having the substantial role, without which we cannot imagine more than 3 days. The food, which is having the crucial role, without which we can't imagine more than 3 weeks. What are all this? All these are the chemical students. All these are the chemicals. So when without the chemical like oxygen, you cannot imagine at least three minutes. Do you feel that the knowledge of the science related to the chemicals is not important for you? So definitely it is needed. It is required for each and every one of us. Because without oxygen, which is the chemical, we cannot imagine 3 minutes. So that is the reason. So definitely each and every person should have the knowledge of the chemistry. Chemistry, why? Because the science related to the chemicals is nothing but the chemistry. So it is that doesn't mean that as it is a part of syllabus, you have to study the chemistry. It is having its significance. It is having its importance. That is the reason you are studying. You are being forced to study the chemistry since your childhood. It doesn't mean that somebody is forcing on you and you have to study. There is an importance. There is a significance associated with the chemistry. That is the reason you have to study the chemistry. You have to study the science which is related to the chemicals. That is the chemistry. Keep this in the mind, students. Each and every subject, whatever you're studying, will have its own significance. First, try to understand what is the importance or significance of that particular subject, that particular topic. That is the reason you are studying that particular topic or that particular subject. You have to realize it. As it is a part of the syllabus, we are studying. No, wrong. It is a part of syllabus. Why? Because there is a lot of significance. There is a lot of importance associated with that. That is the reason it is a part of the syllabus. It is a part of the curriculum. That is the reason you have to study that particular topic or the subject. So some students will create the hatred on the one of the subject. Why? It is important for you, students. But definitely it is important for you. You have to study in order to seek the knowledge, not to gain the knowledge. What not, students? What not? What not? What not? The day you are getting up, what you will do? You'll go for the brush. The brush is made up of the plastic. You'll use this toothpaste, which is made up of the plastic. Right. Then you will wear the fabric, that is cloths. It is made up of the fabric. What is the fabric? Chemical. Right. Not only that, you will go for the bathing. So for bathing, you use the bucket. It is made up of the plastic. Mug made of the plastic. Soap, chemical. Soap is the chemical. Shampoo is the chemical. Right. And when you're sitting in that class, you're using the notebooks. Notebook is made up of what? Bamboo pulp, which is the chemical. What is the chemical present in the bamboo pulp? The chemical present in the bamboo pulp is cellulose, which is the chemical. Right? The spectacles, what you are wearing, it is made of the glass, it's the chemical. The shoe, what you are wearing, is plastic, either the plastic or leather, which is the chemical. It's the chemical. Whatever the pen which you are using to write, it is made up of the plastic, which is the chemical. Whatever the refill which is present in it, it is made up of the plastic, which is the chemical. Whatever the nib is there, it is made up of either the stainless steel or the steel, which is the chemical. Whatever the ink which is present inside the refill, which is a part of the pen, is the chemical, which is the dye. Dye is present as the ink in that, which is the chemical. What not, students? We are surrounded by the chemicals. We are surrounded by the chemicals. When we are surrounded by the chemicals, do you feel that the knowledge of the chemicals is not important for you? So definitely it is important. It is needed for each and every one of us. For some or the other reason, we will be affected by the chemicals for which we have to consume the medicines, which are the chemicals. Which are the chemicals? What not, students? Even I can say that our body is a chemical, students. Our body is a chemical because we are functioning, we are surviving because of the proper functioning of each and every biomolecule present in our body. Just now I have explained to you that our body is made up of or composed of so many biomolecules like amino acids, proteins, enzymes, lipids, DNA, RNA, and so on. Now, when we are functioning with the help of all those chemicals which are present in our body, so definitely we can say that we are the chemical. So being a chemical, do you feel that the knowledge of the science related to the chemicals is not important for you? So definitely it is needed, it is important, it is significant for each and every one of us. That is the reason the chemistry is a part of your syllabus or curriculum since your childhood. But it doesn't mean that something is there in your curriculum, some syllabus is there in your curriculum, and you are forced to study. So please don't do like that. So when the topic is being discussed, whenever the subject is there in front of you, just find out what is the application, what is the importance, what is the significance of that particular topic or the subject. Try to understand that particular thing, that particular aspect. So if you understand what is the importance or the significance of that particular subject in your future, so definitely some sort of curiosity will be developed towards that particular subject. When the curiosity is developed towards that particular subject, automatically what happens? You will keep interest on it. You will turn to that particular subject. No need to force you to sit in the class and listen to the lecture of the chemistry. You will listen on your own when the curiosity is created. So, dear students, please, whenever the topic is being delivered by any of the lecturer, so definitely please ask what is the importance of that particular topic in your day-to-day life, in your future. Then curiosity is developed, then interest is developed, which will not force you, interest, which will not force you in spite of it. It will allow you to be happy to listen to that particular topic or that particular subject very peacefully and calmly. Right. So overall, to sum up, chemistry is used in community, health, environment, medicine, industry, sciences, teaching, research, and finally you and we students. I hope you understood what is the importance of chemistry. Right. So in the next class, I will discuss what is the importance of chemistry in engineering. What is the importance of chemistry for each and every branch of the engineer that I am going to explain to you in the next class. So thanks for watching this video. Thanks once again. Bye.